Hi there, I'm Christian and you're watching A Dev Story, and this is the third video of the Event Driven Architecture series. Today I will be talking about what is event sourcing and what is the Command Query Responsibility Segregation Pattern, or CQRS. So without further ado, let's start. As I mentioned in the previous videos, you can sometimes store the state changes using events. You can then have these events stored in an event log where they are persisted in the order that they appear. When you have this event log, then by reading it, you can recreate the state of an application, and this is what is called event sourcing. Let's go to the example of an e-commerce site that we have seen in previous videos. Let's say we want to keep track of inventory and what is the current inventory. Let's say we have an event called product added that has a product ID and the amount of that product that is added into the inventory. And let's say that when someone buys a product, there is an event called product purchase with a product ID and the amount of that product that was purchased. Now, let's say that we read this and we store it on the event log, and we have first the product added event with 10 products added to this inventory. And let's say later some users buy these products. Maybe once we got a product purchase and then later we got another product purchase for the products. Now we can get what is the current state of inventory at any point just by reading the event log. We know that at one point we added 10 products and then we started purchasing them, right? We purchased 2. So we can calculate that currently the quantity of this product is 8. So the important thing about event sourcing is that we can clear this state at any point. We can delete the number of products, but as long as we keep the event log, we can always calculate what is the current number of products that we have in inventory. Another thing that you can do with event sourcing is temporal queries, where you can go back in time and see what was the state before. For example, let's say that each of these transactions happened on different days. So on day 1, we added 10 products, on day 2, we purchased 1, and on day 3, we purchased another 1. So we can go back and see what was the state on day 2 or day 1. And also for debugging, or if you want to duplicate this data, you just have to replay this event log somewhere else. Of course, there are sometimes some optimizations. Instead of reading all the logs from the beginning, imagine that you have several years. Let's say you are Amazon and you have 15 years of history. You don't want to keep all the events in there. What you can do is to create a snapshot with the current state of the inventory. And then afterwards, you can keep continuing adding more events. And when you're calculating your current state, you can take the snapshot with the additional changes caused by the events. So when is useful event sourcing? So event sourcing is very useful in different scenarios. For example, when you want to have an audit log, when you want to keep track of what has happened in the past, let's say in the repositories when you're using GitHub or Git, you can see what happened when the changes happened. So for audit purposes, the event sourcing is great. Then we have parallel processing. If you have multiple systems reading from the same data source, this is really good because then you can duplicate information in different systems very efficiently. And it's especially useful when you have more readers than writers, because this way each service can read from the event log and store the state by their own. Given that all the events are immutable and the event log itself is immutable, you can then parallelize a lot of processing. For example, if we have in our e-commerce site, we have different services. We have the recommendation, analytics, and inventory services. They can read from the events log and recreate their own state based on what is in the event log. And you can see here a lot of the benefits about having the parallel processing, scalability, and you have a lot more readers than writers in this case. There is something tricky about event sourcing though, that is that you will have eventual consistency. Like, not all the systems will read the events at the same time from the event log. They will have a delays between reads. So in this case, the recommendation analytics and inventory services might be out of sync sometimes when there is a lot of data being read. As soon as there are no more writes into the event log, eventually they will converge into the same value. And this is what is called eventual consistency. Then we get to CQRS, or Command Query Responsibility Segregation Pattern, that is usually used in combination with event sourcing, and we will see why in a moment. Command Query Responsibility Segregation Pattern basically means that you will write the data somehow that is different from the way that you retrieve the data. In the past, you will have maybe the same database where you will do things like you do a put and you do a get. And this is perfectly fine when you have CRUD operations, right? Like I want to write and read exactly from the same data source. But sometimes if you have more reads or more writes, you might want to split this responsibility so you can scale the services differently. Or if you have different views on the data that you have reading, or you get the input somehow and then you process it and get the information in another way, combined with other services, you might want to split also the responsibility between how you write and how you query the data. And this is what the CQRS pattern basically does. Let's see with an example. Let's say we want to add this functionality about having orders overview for a user. We will have these different services, payment, shipping, and order services, and all of them might have recreated the state using the event log. They might be reading the events that have happened in the application, and they know the current state of each of them, like what happened in the payments that have been successful or not, the shipping, what is the current state of the deliveries, for example, and the orders that the user has had in the past. So in this case, an orders overview functionality might need to query three different services to get this information. So as you can see, these different services got the state created by different events that happened in the past. But now this functionality is querying all of these services and combining that data to show that information to the user. The main benefit of using CQRS is that it allows you to split the reads and the writes in different systems. And this allows you to scale them independently. If you're having more reads and writes, or the other way around, you can scale each of these parts independently. You can also have different logic. You can have additional processing when you write, or additional layers or capabilities when you're reading. You can get information from different systems, for example. Another benefit is that it usually goes very well with event-driven architectures and, of course, event sourcing. And you will see that a lot. When you see CQRS, you will usually find it with event sourcing because you are recreating the state using events, but then you are querying them in a different way. The main con of CQRS is that it's a very complex pattern. If your needs are covered by a simple CRUD operation, like you know the typical create, retrieve, update, or delete operation inside the database, then it's usually a better pattern to use because it will simplify a lot. So CQRS is usually a pattern that you will get at one point in the future, like if you start having a lot of imbalance between what you read and what you write, or you're using advanced sourcing, then it might happen that you might want to use CQRS. But usually CQRS should be one of the last resources to use to fix some problems. So try to limit the usage of this pattern. And that's it for today and for the first delivery of the event-driven architecture series. Thank you very much for watching and see you next time.